Hello, my name is Kim, and professor of Kailasaram University, India. Today, I will say about notations used in this lecture, and the frequency, and angular frequency, and the sinusoidals. Finally, why do we have to know the sinusoidal signals? First notation, time, frequency, angular frequency, waveform, spectrum, with respect to analog domain and the digital domain. Now in time, we call it the T, and in digital domain, we denote N. And in case the signal is a period signal, we use this period T, and in this case, this N. Also, this value can take just integer. Integer means 0, 1, 2, 3, like this. Also, minus 1, minus 2, like this. And the frequency in analog domain, we denote capital F. And in digital domain, we denote a small letter F. Means frequency normalized by sampling frequencies. Okay? Then here, maximum frequency is, as you know by sampling theory, Fs by 2. Therefore, F can take minus 0.5 to 0.5. Okay? Angular frequency, this omega equal 2 pi f. And in digital domain, small omega equal 2 pi f. F can take this, therefore omega also can take minus pi to pi. Sometime 0 to 2 pi also we can use. In waveform, small letter x over t, and in digital domain x over n. Spectrum, capital letter x over f, or here in digital domain x over f. Otherwise, x over omega, omega also. Now here, important thing is in analog domain. In analog domain, we are using this capital. In digital domain, we are using the small letter F and omega. This be careful with this one. Do not confuse. Of course, these notations are based on a DSP text by John Prakis. Then, what is the frequency? One object is here. This object moves to like this, or to here, left, right, to left. Okay. Then, this object. How many numbers does this object oscillate during 1 second? That means the numbers of oscillation of repeating event per second. Second, we call this frequency. We denote F. And that the unit is 1 by second. Also, we are using the hertz named F. This German physicist. This one, we are using the hertz. And let's think another kind of this movement of this object. This is it's moving on the circle like this. This okay? Like this is moving. Moving like this one. That means this is the angle theta. Yes. Angle of displacement per second. Per second. That means the angle, the unit of angle, the unit of angle is radian, radian, and per second. How do you call this? That means here, this means now here, 1 by second is frequency. This here, as you can see here, 1 by second. We call this, this concept is frequency. Frequency. Okay? Now the radian is the angular. Therefore, all this one you can say angular frequencies. Otherwise, sometimes you can call angular velocity also. Because 1 by second includes some the velocity concept. That's why we call here angular frequency, otherwise angular velocity. Have you ever seen this kind of spectrum? This axis is frequency, and this is plus frequency, minus frequency. This also, with respect to this, plus and minus. Also, this kind. This one is a kind of some of the filter. And how do you think? What kind of this filter? Low pass filter, high pass, band pass, band stop filter. Is there someone who think that this is the band pass filter? Is this okay? Okay. Let me think about this from now. This is the band filter or not? Okay, for this, let me think the current in electric circuit. For example, here, this is the 1 ohm is here, and so 1 volt here, 1 volt. Then I call, this is 1 ampere. Also another one is 1 ohm, same one, and the source, voltage source is different. This is plus minus this one. This is also 1 volt and 1 ohm. Then this is also 1 ampere. But as you know, in this case, plus minus, the current is like this clockwise. In this case, plus minus, the current is like this counterclockwise. That's therefore, same 1 ampere, but different direction, we call this plus and minus like this. Okay? Like this, there are two objects here. One is moving like this, left to right. Okay? This one, like this, right to left. Okay, these two objects also oscillated one time per second. Therefore, this is 1 hertz. This is also 1 hertz. Okay, but the direction is different. We call this plus, and you can say this minus. Okay. Okay. Then let's think another kind of this object move here. This object is moving on this circle like this. Okay, like this object is here. Okay, this. In this case, we can show the graph. This plus, minus. And this is the one circle means 2π. This is 2π. 2π. During 1 second, one time oscillated. Now here, this also, this one is like this. Okay. Then the graph is we can show like this. Then this is also one hertz. One hertz because one time oscillate, one time circled, rotated during 1 second. But in this case, direction is this direction, this is direction. Therefore, this is plus minus. This is this object is rotated this way. We call this omega. Therefore, we can say 2π1 radian per second. And in this case, omega equal minus 2π radian per second. Okay. Like this, you know this plus, minus, plus, minus. Mathematically okay. Also, frequency can have a plus F and a minus F. Let me prove this one. For this, you know this piece, the Euler, Leonhard, Euler, Switzerland. Okay? You know, Euler formula. E theta equal cosine theta plus j sine theta. You know? From this, cosine theta equal like this. Here, instead of z, we can substitute 2πft. Then this cosine theta can say cosine 2πft equal 1/2 e power of j 2πft plus exponential j 2π minus ft like this. And here you can say you can know this f plus f consists of plus f and minus f like this. Therefore, mathematically also it's the f can take plus and the minus is can take. Then how about this? This filter is a band filter. Is this okay? Okay, and not is it, that's not that it, it's wrong, because just we think the times of ovulation, then we don't need to this part. Then we can use this just plus. Then this is a low pass filter. In the world, like this, in the world, there are some boys and girls. Also, black is here and white is here. Also, G equal here and conjugated here, like this. Also, frequency also plus F and minus F. So, I exist this. Then, what is the sinusoidal signals? For this, let me think. This one, here, one object. One object is here. One object is here. One object is here. Okay. Now we're thinking from this. Of course, this object from here to like this is moving on the circle. Okay, and like this is theta. We call this height. Okay. Let me check the height according to the moving of this object. It's okay. Then from this object is here. This x is a theta. Then this is 0π/2. This is a pi. This is a 3π/2. This is 2π. Theta equal 0 means here, then the height is 0. Okay, now object is here. Then height is like this. Then here, here. Then the object is here, then it equal π/2. Height is this. object is here, the height is this one. Here. And object is here, the height is zero. Okay? And the object move to here, then height is minus this one, the minus this one. And the object is here, then height is this. Object here, height is this. Then come here, height is zero. Then we connect these lines, we can get okay, this kind of curve. Get this curve. Next, let me think base of this base of the this object. For this, you can see here, this is 0, this is pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2, this is 2 pi. Okay, object is here. Then base is this one, then this one. Moved here, then base is here, this kind, okay, this one. Moved here, the space is 0. Next, moved here, the base is go like this. Now this one. And moved to here, base is go like this, this one, this one. And here, okay, base is 0. And move the here, like this. Then we can connect all these lines. We can okay, like this. Okay. Okay. Now from this, from the movement of these particles, we can measure the base and height. We can get two kind of kind of a graph like this. Now here, this means sine curve. Therefore, the red, we call this sine theta. Also, this means cosine. That's what this green line is cosine theta like this. Also, these are sinusoidal signals. Okay. Then, sinusoidal signals are just a function of angle. Just a function of angle. That's answer is no. For example, theta angle can be function of t. This means theta equal function of t. Okay. Then the sine theta means sine instead of theta, you can take it apple of t. We call this 2 pi f t. Then from this sine 2 pi f t. This is the where this is a function, this is variable, therefore this we call this x over t. More generally we can say x over t equal a times over sine 2 pi f t plus some function is here. Okay, then what is graph? How to plot this one? Now here let me assume a equal 5, amplitude 5, f equal 10 hertz, phase equal, let me think, 0. Then from this we can get this kind graph. Now this is 0, this is 0.1 here. But you can see here, this is the one. This is from here to here, we call this one period. One period. Then how to know period? From this, t equal 1 by f equal 1 by f equal 1 by 10 equal 0.1 second. That's t equal 0.1 second. For here too, here you know this one. This is t. And this is the amplitude. Not here to here. Okay, this is not amplitude. From here to here, we call this amplitude. Okay. Then, how about this one? How to plot this x of t equal 5 sine? Okay. Now, 5 means amplitude. 5 means amplitude. Okay. From this, f equal, we know, 10 hertz. The periodical, this one. By the way, what is pi? Right? We have to plot this signal on the time domain. Then we have to shift. Minus means shift. Shift to right. Then we have to know pi. What is pi? Now this is a radian, okay? Pi radian. Then from this, we have to know pi radian correspond to what second? We know this one, we can transfer from here to here, we can shift, okay. Now how do we know this one? From this, we can know t second. T second means 2 pi radian. Okay. Now t equal 0.1 second. Okay. Therefore, pi radian means you can know this is 2 pi means 0.1 second. The pi means 0.05 second. Then we can shift to the right 0.05 second like this. Now here, good. Okay. Now here too. Here, 0.05 moved, shift to the right. Okay, this is okay. Okay, then another one thing, you can do this. You can change the equations. This one to here, compact. From this, we can know the 0.05. We can shift. This is also another way. Then, why do we have to know sinusoidal signals? Okay, now here, salt is here. We divide, we can get molecule NaCl. And one more time divide, you can get this Na atom and the Cl atom. This. From this, we cannot divide. For example, we cannot divide, we cannot divide. Therefore, atom means smallest element of some of the materials. Okay? Like this signal also. Arbitrary signal is here. This signal consists of many kind of sinusoidal signals like this. Therefore, sinusoidal means basic signals of arbitrary signals like this. Like this, okay? Atom is the smallest one. Atom like this. Sinusoid also basic signals of this all kind of signals. Mathematically also, we can say this. X of t can be represented like this. Okay. This means, what this means? Cosine omega t plus j sine omega t. What is this one? This means sinusoidal signals. Sinusoidal signals. Therefore, we have to know the sinusoidal signals for knowing arbitrary signals. But this is the source plan for your reference. Thank you very much for your watching today. I lectured concept of frequency, angular frequency, minus frequency, sinusoidal, and why do you have to know the sinusoidal signals. Next, I'll explain delta step signal, syncope signals. look forward to next video. Thank you very much again.